Thank you to everybody who has helped me to reach 300,000 subscribers. I couldn't have done it without you. As always, each square represents a subscriber. Each is a living, breathing person, or possibly one of the bots that I've paid to subscribe to me. This video is dedicated to those computer players who make our lives better, who have made Counter-Strike what it is today. Back in Source, they were touted as being some of the most advanced ever created. They could work their way around maps never seen before, and would even shoot out breakable items that were in the way. I made my own maps at the time, and moved from Half-Life 2 to Source just because of the bot support. They're the reason I started playing Counter-Strike, and I had many happy hours playing with and against them. This video is a tribute to those unsung heroes of Counter-Strike. Open up a file called Bot Profile within the CS Strike folder, and their inner workings will be revealed. Each and every bot has custom stats ranging from aggression to teamwork. This file contains a lot of history. You'll see a voice pitch option dating back to Source, and a cost option from back in Condition Zero where you could hire them to fight for you in the single player campaign. Good times. There are 8 different preset skill levels, each with better accuracy and reflexes than the previous one. But wait, I hear you cry. There are only 4 in game. True. Easy bots make up the lowest of the 8. Normal, the 2nd and 3rd. Hard contains the 3 categories above that, and Expert, the 2 above that. This means that even within the same difficulty level, some bots are better than others. Apart from Easy, where they're all terrible. So who's the best? Well, I'm not going to degrade them to fighting in pits. It would take a really twisted, sick person to do something like that. But here's a list of the elite skilled bots, and of them, Cliff, Wolf, Steel and Gunner are the most likely to use AKs and M4s, so because of that I'd fear them the most in play. That's also because, with the exception of snipers, they handle all weapons in the same way. It doesn't matter if they're armed with a shotgun, SMG or M4. You'll notice that they'll never use the scope on the AUG or SG because of this. An interesting side effect is that expert bots do badly with SMGs since they refuse to spray and pray with them unless at very close range, where they seem to panic with any weapon type. Even with perfect settings in the bot config, there's a built-in delay to their aiming, which means that they'll miss almost every shot if you run across their vision. Terrifyingly, they always aim for your dick, even if it's concealed behind cover. If the majority of your body is hidden, like say if you're crouched behind a barrel or crate, they'll forget that you're there but will remember your position. I saw bots use this as an opportunity to try and plant, or to try and flank the player's hiding position. If, God forbid, they get hold of the bomb, they immediately rush towards the site. I'm sure that we've all experienced this behaviour in matchmaking at some point. If Valve wanted to, they could make bots follow orders and leave objectives to players. They could make them run as fast as humans. Their game sense and aim could also be majorly improved. But Valve won't do any of this, because otherwise teams would kick their worst players in favour of bots, to serve as a spare life for the first player who dies. The poor things don't stand a chance with the limitations that Valve has put on them. But we can improve them in some ways. Helping me with this video is
Bezmienny,
who I'd consider a bot expert and has spent years analysing their behaviour and pushing their abilities to the max. Using these console commands, you can see a map's nav mesh. These blocks tell bots how to move around the level, where to hide, where to expect enemies from, where the best sniper spots are, and how to traverse obstacles. CSGO automatically generates these for custom-made levels and does an okay job, but still leaves considerable room for improvement. By customizing it, bots can become far better at playing the levels that we all know and love. To show what bots are capable of, Bez showed me an assault course. It's not hard for human players, but I couldn't imagine a bot being able to do it in a million years. But sure enough, they did, all thanks to a custom nav mesh that he had made. I'll show a quick extract of the course he showed me here. I hope you find it as interesting as I did.
He has some trouble jumping on those boxes because there's a gap in here. Normally this doesn't happen on the maps, so it shouldn't be a problem.
The first real challenge came with the van, which didn't have an invisible clip to make it easy to climb on. Because of this, jumping onto it was very glitchy, and even I struggled. Bez warned me that the bots sometimes get stuck, but it's a fault with the map more than it is with the pathfinding.
Come on! I believe in you!
Oh, I'm not the enemy!
Oh my god. Please. Oh yes, finally. Yeah, but normally it doesn't happen, because it happens only here because there's a player clip missing.
He then showed me the ultimate challenge, where the bot had to jump across a gap. I'm sure we've all seen how bots usually deal with this sort of obstacle. And he found his solution in the most unlikely of places. It turns out that Valve knew how to get a jump like this to work, but only included it in one spot. Here, in the most unlikely of places. It involves a no-jump zone that acts as a run-up, followed by a thin jump zone on the very edge, encouraging bots to make the leap. He's not entirely sure why this was included in this location, since bots wouldn't successfully manage a jump this far anyway, but he thinks that maybe they're supposed to fail, so they return to ground level again. If Valve had included a proper connection between the roof and ground zones, then it could perhaps confuse bots already at ground level, who might try to jump up onto the roof, failing in a perpetual cycle. He then demonstrated why the correct start position and run-up was so important. A lot was on the line, and the bot knew it. Using this run-up method, the bot did both jumps first time and even successfully navigated the crouching tunnel. The whole thing was impressive stuff to see in action and could dramatically improve the navigation in official maps, which Bess has also done. Through analysing the meshes that Valve has made, he has rated the official maps. Of course, it depends on the paths they take and how you wish to rate them, but he was impressed with Italy and gave it a 9. Presumably a custom nav mesh was needed to help get them up this wood stack near CT spawn. He said that even this map's nav mesh is out of date though. He awarded the new trainer 1 for simply being a pre-generated nav mesh, with no love or attention given to it by the devs. He also found a lot of peculiar mistakes. For example, bots will still walk around the scaffolding in Dust 2's tunnels, even though it was removed years ago. He still rated the map's mesh a 7 overall. At CT spawn on short dust, there's an invisible car which confuses bots running through this area. Valve, please fix. But he doesn't just criticise what's already there. He's taken steps to improve the nav mesh on these maps. Mirage in particular. He made it so they could jump back into the apartments in A, or through the ladder room like so. None of this was possible before, although you might not have noticed. Not all changes were so acrobatic. He made this spot near T-spawn one way, so bots can drop down but have to walk up the stairs again to get back up, as opposed to getting bugged on the slope and doing a needless jump going down. The best course of action totally depends on the situation. His advice to mapmakers is to spend just a few minutes testing the nav mesh, to lead a bot around from place to place, and to see if they get stuck on railings or if they camp in bad corners. It doesn't take long to do, and ironing out these problems will quickly make bots more fun to play with on these maps. You can download the improved nav meshes in this video's description, which I'll try to keep up to date with his latest changes and additions. You can also download this bot script from Game Banana. This will improve their skill level, though be warned, it does mean that even on easy mode, you might find yourself against the elite of the bot army. Or perhaps you won't bother. Clearly, bots aren't important to anybody, not even map developers. But since most maps will at some point need bots to increase player numbers, perhaps a little more care and respect should be given to them. So let's thank bots for their years of service. When human players have failed us, they've always been patiently waiting in the wings, ready to step in. They'll take whatever we throw at them, often having to ignore a horrifying barrage of team attacks and insults. They're the heroes that we deserve, if not the ones we need right now. We joke about them because they can take it. Because they're not heroes. They're silent guardians, watchful protectors, and a bit shite.